Okay, hello guys, welcome back. Now let's continue the previous video at which we will discuss how to install Python 3.10 manually by downloading the Python package from the official website. Okay, now we'll go to your browser and type python.org in the search bar, then hit enter. As you can see here, as we have said before on the previous video on explaining how to install Python in Windows 10, we have various tabs and we discussed the interface of that site quickly. You can go back to our video in the description below or feel free to discover it yourself. But now let's hit download directly. As you can see, the website detected directly your operating system type and downloaded it in .tar.xz extension for compressed files specific to Linux. And if you try to download it and your computer running on Windows 10, then your download file extension will be detected automatically and will be downloaded as .xe file. Okay, now go to your download location and extract the file, whether easily using the GUI way like that, or right click, open your terminal in that folder and type the tar command, then space, and specify your options by typing -xvf, where x option is used to tell the command to extract that file, then the v option for verbose or display the details of extraction on the terminal here, and f option tells tar to create an archive file with the same name of that compressed file to store the output files of the or the extracted files resulted from the decompression process. Otherwise, the output files resulted will be extracted in the same directory file and it will look nasty. Okay. As you can see here, the decompressed folder that is created, open it. Then we will open the terminal in that folder, type ls. As you can see, all of the files are listed. And those green highlighted files indicate that they are executables. And our main concern here is the configure file. Simply execute this by typing .config, which is a tool used to prepare the building process of Python packages that will be installed after that. And type space, then the flag, which is --. With -ensure pep equal to install, which is used to ensure that the included or bundled pep that version is installed, and it will take some time. And after it's finished, then type sudo apt install space build-essential, which is called a meta package, and those meta packages actually doesn't install anything to your system, but instead it provides a link to other required packages, act as dependencies needed. So we can see they are actually a script to install those dependencies. Then after it finished, type make command. This make command has a long story, but for now you need to know by convention, make is simply a utility used to build and maintain a group of programs from their source code, and here it's used to determine automatically the pieces of program that need to be recompiled again. As you can see, after we hit enter, it starts building and maintaining needed directories of libraries, or they are considered a programs that are stored in a file named makefile. That you could notice that when we typed ls and listed all of the files in that Python 3.10 directory, add that file named makefile, we have those dependencies stored, see the file that need, and by that make command we could see the file that need to be recompiled, as we said, and compile it and build the targets desired from those dependencies. Okay, and after it's done, just type the sudo make out install command to install this new version without overriding the system or the installed or the previous installed version. And if there are some problems with this command, try sudo make install rather than alt install or the alternative install. Okay. After that, let's try to check our Python 3 install version. Open your terminal and type Python 3-- version. The 3.10 should be appeared, but if it's not shown, then try Python 3.10 space --- version and hit enter. And if it's installed, then you will see that. Okay, now we need to install some other libraries and dependencies to complete the 3.2 version. And I want to show you a very important tool that we will get some help from it, and you might know it. It's called a Synaptic Manager, which is a package manager installing system for Linux systems. And simply, all of the previous instructions to install Python 3.10 can be applied directly from that tool. But first, you can install the Synaptic tool by using sudo apt install synaptic, then -y stands for yes, then hit enter, and it will be installed successfully. Now open it, and it will ask for your password if you logged in as a user, not a root user to your Linux. Okay, here, as you can see, it has a very simple interface, and if you want to download anything, just click here at the search icon and type what you want, or any program or package. And let's try to install Python 3.10 libraries or dependencies that is actually a complementary libraries for that version. Just type here Python 3.10 and hit search, and all of the installing packages for that version will appear. And try to mark for installing and select all the uninstalled packages and dependencies. Once you click on them, here you'll choose mark for uninstallation. I did that before. You try to do this by yourself. After you finish, hit apply here, then click apply again. Wait for the downloading packages and automatic installing. And yeah, that's it for that video. I wish you know something new from watching this, and see you later in my upcoming videos. Goodbye.